Hello, children of Standard 8. Today we are going to discuss the topic Indian Judiciary, the Supreme Court of India. Judiciary is a collective term for all the courts of India. The judiciary consists of the Supreme Court and the High Court and also various subordinate courts. In this lesson, you have to learn the Supreme Court and the High Court, their composition, qualifications of judges and appointment. Supreme Court in India, we have a single integrated means coming together, judiciary system. The Supreme Court is the highest of all courts and it's called as the apex court. Below it come the high courts and below it comes the subordinate courts. Here again, I am explaining it once more. We have a single unified judiciary. The subordinate court, the district court, and the high courts are all subject to the control of the Supreme Court. The law declared by the Supreme Court shall be binding on all courts within the territory of India. It means that the Supreme Court is the final arbiter of laws. The law that is said by the Supreme Court will be final and all for all the other courts. The subordinate courts and high courts are subject to the control of the Supreme Court, which is the highest judicial body in India. That is why Supreme Court is also called as final interpreter and guardian of the Constitution. Interpreter means one who interprets laws and also guardian of the Constitution. The Supreme Court and the High Court protects the fundamental rights. Composition of the Supreme Court. In accordance with the Act of 2008, the Supreme Court consists of the Chief Justice of India and not more than 30 other judges. Every judge of the Supreme Court is appointed by the President after consultation with the Chief Justice of India. The Chief Justice of India will be appointed on the basis of seniority. Qualification for oath of office. The judge of the Supreme Court must be a citizen of India, must have been in a high court for at least 5 years, or an advocate of a high court for at least 10 years. Must be, in the opinion of the President, a distinguished jurist. Oath of office. Every judge before enters into office takes an oath administered by the President of India. Term of office. A judge retires at the age of 65 years. A judge may be removed from office by the President on the grounds of proved misbehavior or incapacity. Jurisdiction and functions of the Supreme Court. Jurisdiction is the power that a court of law exercises to carry out judgments, to interpret laws, and to settle disputes. At high courts, at the state level, the Constitution provides for a high court, which is the highest judicial organ in the state. The Parliament may also establish a common high court for one or more states and union territories. At present, there are 24 high courts in India. Composition of the High Court. The High Court consists of a Chief Justice and such other judges as the President may appoint from time to time. The number of judges in a High Court is not fixed. It varies from state to state. The Chief Justice of High Court is appointed by the President in consultation with the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court and the Governor of the concerned state. The other judges are also appointed in the same manner with the consultation of the Chief Justice of the Chief Justice of the concerned state. Qualifications for being a judge of the High Court: should be a citizen of India, should have at least 10 years of experience as an advocate of High Court, or should have at least 10 years of experience as a judicial officer in the territory of India.